Hello, my name is Ryan Weatherby. I work at the Office of Assessment here at Hudson. And I'm going to give you a tutorial on how to use ExamSoft and Examplify, which is the computer-based testing platform we use here at Hudson. The first thing to do is to check your email inbox for an email from me with the subject header installation and registration instructions. In this email, you'll find directions on how to download Examplify, which is the program that you'll need for doing tests on test day. As well as your login information, how to log into the ExamSoft website. And it's the same login information that you'll use when you log into Examplify. I'll go over that a little bit more later. If you're going to use an iPad for tests, just go to the App Store and search for Examplify, and you can download the Examplify app that way. Examplify is only supported on Windows-based PCs, Macs, and iPads. No other tablets or Chromebooks are supported right now. So the first part of this is the ExamSoft website. The whole system is called ExamSoft. Examplify is just the program that you download to take tests, but it's part of the larger ExamSoft system. So on the ExamSoft website, if you've downloaded the program, you've already logged in here. And you'll see that you can do a couple of things on the website. One is to monitor your test-taking activities under the Courses tab at the top. You can monitor your performance across different learning outcomes. And this is one of the main reasons we use Examplify and ExamSoft, is that we can track how you're doing across different learning outcomes, which can be very useful to you. Go to the Performance tab at the top, and you can run your own reports to see how you're doing and how you compare to other students. This becomes more and more useful as you've taken more and more tests in Examplify. So for those of you that are further along in your program, this becomes more useful. You can also manage your account, and this basically means you can change your password at any time. So the password that was auto-generated for you is hard to remember, so you might want to change that to something that's easier to remember. We do have two portals here at Hudson. If you're not in the School of Pharmacy, the portal you would log into would be examsoft.com/Hudson. If you are in the School of Pharmacy, it's examsoft.com/HudsonPharm. So Examplify is the other component of this system. It's the program that you actually download to your computer or your iPad. And it is what you will use when you're taking a test on test days. So you'll come in on a test day, you'll open up Examplify, and log in, and then what it does is it secures your computer. So it locks down your computer so that you can't use any other programs during a test, and it even turns off the internet so you can't access the internet. And we call this a secure testing environment. So the things that I want to make sure that you are able to do by the end of this training are that you have Examplify installed and working on your computer. I would recommend going ahead and doing that right now. And you can come back to the video once that's done. If you haven't been able to install it correctly, please contact me or your instructor and we can help you out. You can also contact ExamSoft support directly, and their phone number is right on the main ExamSoft website. So go to examsoft.com/Hudson or Hudson Firm, and you'll see their phone number down in the bottom right-hand corner. So once it's installed, you can come back to this video, and then what we're gonna do is I'm gonna walk you through how to download a practice quiz, take that practice quiz, and then upload it again. And that three-step process is something you'll have to do for every test that you take in ExamSoft. And the purpose of this tutorial is just to make sure that everything's running properly on your computer so that you're ready for test day. You don't have any technical glitches. Before you start using Examplify, ExamSoft highly recommends that you disable all your virus checkers. Examplify basically takes over your computer during the time that you're taking a test, and some virus checkers don't like that, and they'll try to block Examplify from working. So to prevent that from happening, go ahead and disable your virus checker. Just do this before you start Examplify, and then also obviously re-enable your virus checker after you're done using Examplify. While you're using the program, you're not at any risk of getting a virus on your computer because the internet is turned off anyway, and you can't get a virus on your computer if the internet's turned off. If you're not sure how to disable your particular virus checker, I've provided a link here that will take you to the ExamSoft website, and they show instructions on how to download all the common and not so common virus checkers. You can also just Google ExamSoft virus disable. We also recommend that you close all other programs that you have open on your computer before you start. This just speeds up the process of starting a test. You don't want to get into a test on exam day and be waiting for Examplify to shut down all your running programs. Sometimes it even runs into problems shutting down certain programs. So if you do that beforehand, everything should go more smoothly on exam day. Okay, so once you have Examplify installed, go ahead and open it. The icon for Examplify should show up on your desktop if you're a Windows user. If you're on a Mac, it probably just ended up in your applications folder, so go find it there. When you do open it for the first time, and almost every time after that, if you have to re-log in, there'll be this licensing agreement. So just scroll down through all this text, and when you do that, the I agree button will turn green, and you can press it and move to the next screen. The first time you log in, you're going to have to add a new account. So go ahead and hit the Add New Account button. You'll then be prompted to indicate what institution you're at. So just start typing Husson and two things should appear, Husson and Husson Farm. Just make sure you select the correct one for whatever program you're in. Now you have to enter your ID and password, and this information was in that email that was sent to you. So again, look for the email with the subject installation and registration instructions from me. Your ID is the same number that's on the back of your Eagle card. It only has numbers, no letters, and your password is in that email. Once you're past the login screen, this is what you'll see. This is the main Examplify screen. On the left-hand side, you'll see a list of any tests that are waiting for you to download. So how it works is because you're offline when you're taking the test, you have to download the test first, the test file. So you can do that as soon as it's posted by your instructor. And we usually recommend that your instructors make these available at least a day or two before the exam. So you should go ahead and download it as soon as you can. Don't wait until you get into the classroom on the day of the test. Because if there are any internet problems on campus that day, you may not be able to download your exam file and you won't be able to start your test. So make sure you do this before class, the day of your test. Come into class with it already downloaded. So just select the name of the one that you need to download. For the practice test that we're going to be doing today, it's called 2018 Examplify Orientation. So you should see that. If you don't see that in the left-hand list, first thing to try is to click the refresh exam list button at the bottom. For some reason, sometimes they don't automatically show up until you hit that refresh button. If it's still not showing up, you'll have to contact me or your instructor and we can help you out. It probably means that for some reason you're not in the class roster. So go ahead, select the 2018 Examplify Orientation test file, hit the download exam, the big green download exam button, and the file should download pretty quickly. Once it's downloaded, this is again a reminder to download it. Once it's downloaded, you are ready to start the exam. And what will happen during an exam day is that your instructor will have to send you or provide you in some way. Usually if it's in class, they'll just write it on the whiteboard at the front of the classroom. If it's an online test, they'll have to send it to you some way. And what it is this exam password is needed for you to start the actual exam. So you can download the test file anytime you want after it's posted, but you can't go any further with the exam until your instructor provides you the exam password. Today we're going to be using the password 123QWE. It is case sensitive, so be careful about that. So just type that in where it says exam password. I should also point out that there are some other information at the bottom of this screen. And these are the options that have been set for this particular test. So there are things like, has the spell checker been enabled? Are you allowed to have access to a calculator within the program? Are you able to go backwards and forwards through the test? Those type of things are set by your instructor. And you can also see what the time limit for the test is, which can be very useful. If you have any accommodations on record with Husson, time accommodations for testing, those will automatically be added to the system and should be reflected in your time limit. So once you put the exam password in, you can hit the start exam button. You'll be prompted with a warning just telling you that you should save all your work, disable your virus checker. You can hit continue there. And then you'll have one last just a prompt to make sure that you really want to start the exam. A code will be shown on your screen. It can be either numbers or letters. The program is just asking you to repeat that code in the blanks provided. So in my case, it's JKST. I would just type JKST in those blanks. And when I do that correctly, the start exam button will light up and I can start my exam. Okay, so at this point, I would recommend you go ahead and just finish watching this video and then go in and actually start the exam. So you can't do the test exam, the test quiz, and watch this video at the same time because it's gonna lock down your computer. So just finish watching the video first and then go back and start the exam. The quiz, I should say. So in this quiz, it's, I think, 8 questions, and it just read the question and do what it's asking so that you become more familiar with the testing environment and the options within Examplify so that you're ready to use it with any problems on exam day. There's a question that asks you to use the spell checker. Make sure you can figure out how to do that. It's just like any other spell checker. You just hover over the misspelled word and then a list of possible spellings will pop up. There's a question that asks you to find an attachment because your instructors can post attachments to each of the exam questions and attachments to the overall exam as well. There's a question that asks you to find the calculator. So just make sure that you're paying attention to what it's asking you in each question. When you get to the last question, after you finish the last question, the next button at the bottom will be grayed out. You can't go any further. And it's not completely obvious what you're supposed to do at that point. But at this point, you're done the exam, so you're ready to submit it. So go up to the left-hand exam control menu, the top of the screen. And when that pops down, there'll be a submit exam button that you can press. You'll have to check the little green, I'm ready to exit my exam button, and then hit the big green exit button. You can also return to the exam if you want at this point. There's that return to exam option, but when you are ready to finally upload, make sure you follow this sequence. At this point, the internet will be turned back on your computer. And once that happens successfully, your exam file will be uploaded to the server. When the server receives your file, it will send a message back to your computer and this green confirmation screen will come on. So it's a multi-step process. The server has to receive the file, and then the server has to send a message back to your computer. Once you've seen this green confirmation screen that says congratulations, you are done. The exam has been uploaded. You can close out of Examplify at this point. I recommend that you restart your computer at this point just to make sure all the settings are back to normal. Examplify can have problems making all your settings exactly the way they were. So usually when you restart your computer, that solves those problems. If you were not able to see this green screen and you saw another color screen, that means your exam file was not uploaded successfully. So usually that means you weren't able to connect to the internet properly and you may have to manually try to connect to the internet, and then there'll be a try again button that you can press. Don't worry, if you're still not able to successfully upload your exam file, just contact your instructor or me and we can walk you through that process. The exam file has not been lost. It's still on your computer. If worse comes to worse, we can do a manual upload. So don't worry about that too much. But do worry about seeing this green screen at some point in your exam process. And if you're not able to see it immediately, please go ahead and if you're not able to rectify the situation on your own, contact us so we can make sure that we have your exam file on record. That's about it. There'll be some instructions in Canvas for you to follow just to make sure that you're able to do this quiz and this orientation. Make sure you follow those instructions. And if you have any problems, contact me at weatherbr@huston.edu. Thank you very much. Good luck.